Hey, it's Professor Dave. Let's talk about hemiacetals, acetals, and imines.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
So let's take a look at some interesting aqueous equilibria that we can see. Let's say we have this aldehyde right here. Now, what can happen is this carbonyl oxygen can protonate. And so there we have that right there. And now let's say we have some alcohol in solution. So we've got this aldehyde in acidic conditions and we've got some alcohol. Well, this alcohol certainly can attack right here because this carbonyl carbon is very electrophilic because it also has this formal positive charge on the oxygen. That oxygen really wants to become neutralized. So this alcohol can attack right there. This pi bond can go ahead and neutralize that oxygen. So now we've got that right here, and now some molecule and solvent, like another molecule of alcohol, let's say, can go ahead and grab that proton. We don't really care what it is. In general, something's gonna grab that proton, and we're gonna get to the hemiacetal. So this is called a hemiacetal because this is the hemiacetal carbon. It is a carbon that is bound to OR and OH, R being any alkyl. So O and more alkyl and then OH. If both of those are on one carbon, that is called a hemiacetal carbon. But it doesn't have to stop at the hemiacetal because let's say this hydroxyl goes ahead and protonates further. So now we've got a water leaving group. Well, what we can do, one way of thinking of it is it just leaves just like a normal SN1 reaction, but a way that makes a little more sense is let's say that this pi bond goes ahead and puts that over there. And so this is essentially gonna kick off the water. So we're losing H2O, right? We've lost a water molecule there. Now that we have OR, now this is opening it up to, again, like this situation is analogous to this situation here. We've got a carbon doubly bound to an oxygen with a formal positive charge. Carbon double bond oxygen, formal positive charge. So this is susceptible to attack again by another molecule of the alcohol. So let's say this R prime OH, now we've got another R prime OH. Now let's say let's say it's another molecule of alcohol. We're not sure what it is, could be a water molecule, doesn't matter. Something's gonna grab this and go ahead and neutralize that. And now we have R, and we have a carbon right here attached to OR. And that's what's called an acetal, because we have a carbon attached to OR and OR. So hemiacetal, hemi meaning almost like half, we've got OROH is a hemiacetal, and an acetal is OROR attached to the same carbon. So this is chemistry that happens a lot in the body. It has to do with how certain molecules cyclize, carbohydrates, things like that. And one interesting thing to note is that all of these are acid-base equilibria, and that means they're all completely reversible. So what this means is that to go in this reverse direction, this oxygen could protonate and we'd get this. And then this oxygen could kick that off and we'd get this. And then water could attack right here, neutralize that, and we'd get this. We could lose a proton and we'd get this. And then we could, what's going on here? And then this could protonate right there and we'd get this guy. And then this could come down and kick that off, and we'd be over here. And then we could lose that proton and we'd be back to here. So every single thing in this reaction is reversible. So it's not that it's unidirectional and we start here and we're gonna get there. But the thing is that we can tweak this equilibrium and have one direction preferred. For example, if we have an excess of alcohol, if we have a lot of alcohol molecules in this solution, then every time an alcohol molecule sees something like this, it's gonna go ahead and attack. It's gonna drive the direction this way. That's basic Le Chatelier's principle, right? We're saying we're adding one thing, it's going to push the equilibrium to the other side. Another thing we could do is remove water. If we remove water, it's going to push it towards this direction. Then again, if we add a lot of water and have not a lot of alcohol molecules, we have a lot of water molecules, then water is going to go ahead and attack here, push everything back in this direction. So this is completely an acid-base equilibrium. We're seeing how aldehydes can generate, with alcohols, can generate hemiacetals and acetals. So let's look at another functional group that forms very similarly to the way that hemiacetals and acetals form, and that's an imine. So this time we're going to react this ketone, instead of an alcohol, we're going to react it with this amine. So let's take the lone pair on the nitrogen. This is going to be just fine to go ahead and attack here. and what we're going to get is this over there. And now, when we're in these kinds of aqueous conditions, we can sort of take proton transfer as rendered, because there's a lot of water molecules, there's a lot of molecules floating around in solution that are going to be able to swap protons. So let's just say this oxygen ion is going to go ahead and grab two protons, and then sometimes when we just want to hand wave a proton transfer, we can do these little hook arrows. So that is not a traditional electron pushing arrow. An electron pushing arrow always goes from electron rich to electron poor, but sometimes we just want to say, this proton is gone. We don't care what took it, solvent molecule, whatever. And so that's going to do that, and we're going to neutralize that nitrogen. So now we've got this water leaving group, and we've got this nitrogen over here that has now been neutralized. This can go ahead and kick off this water molecule right there. So here we are here. Once again, we have a positive charge, and we've formed this over here. But instead of what we had with the alcohol, where another alcohol is going to attack over here, instead, we can just hook off this hydrogen again, go right there, and we are going to form an imine. So an imine is anytime you have a carbon with a double bond to a nitrogen. So here's our imine right here. Once again, just like hemiacetal and acetal formation, these are all equilibria that are completely reversible. So once again, we could protonate right here. We could have water attack right here. We could lose these protons, protonate right there, and then this could come down and then kick off the amine. So this can all go all the way back that way as well. But at any rate, we are looking at some acid-base equilibria that, some acidic conditions, aqueous equilibria that are going to be able to generate imines as well as hemiacetals and acetals. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.